Hi everyone, today we are going to discuss about handling retry option with the Spring Boot application. The first step, now I am going to download the Gradle project from Spring Initializer webpage. So here I provided the group name and then the artifact name. Artifact name I given Spring Retry. This is the artifact name I am giving. And then we need to add the web dependency for writing a REST controller and then retry option, Spring Retry, and then the Spring Aspect dependencies. Spring Aspect dependencies is needed for writing a retry option in Spring Boot application. Okay, so I downloaded the project and then extracted the zip file. Import the Gradle project into your Eclipse. Use existing Gradle project option to import it. Provide the project root directory here. Click next, next, and finish. Okay, so the Gradle project will imported successfully into your Eclipse. And then the first step, go to the build.gradle file. Okay, Spring Retry. Go to the build.gradle file. In the build.gradle file, make sure the dependencies is added or not. Spring Boot Shorter AOP and Spring Retry and Spring Boot Shorter Web Dependency. And then go to the main Spring Boot application class file that is annotated with the @ Spring Boot application. Okay. This is the main Spring Boot application class file. Here I am going to add the @ REST controller annotation to write a REST endpoint. So I added the @ REST controller annotation. And then now I am going to write a new API. I mean, this is the default API. That method is request method is get method. Okay, request mapping value is the default context path, and then the method is a request method is get. Okay, this method is returning a simple string like success. So whoever calling this API, they will get the string response success. Okay, so I just imported the request method get. Okay, so we return a simple REST endpoint. Now I am going to add the @ enable retry annotation in your main Spring Boot application class file. This annotation is used to retry the method with the number of attempts we mentioned if any exception is occurred. So here I am adding the retryable annotation for the myApp method. So this method should be retry if any exception are occurred with the specified n number of times. Okay, so here I provided the retryable option, I mean annotation, number format exception and null pointer exception, and then the maximum attempts is 5. So this method, if any exception is occurred, like number format exception or null pointer exception is occurred, it will retry, I mean it will call this API again and again with the specified maximum number of attempts. Okay, so if it fails after the maximum number of attempts reach, if it is fails, we need to write a recover method. That method should be annotated with the @ recover annotation. Okay, so we specified the two exceptions, number format exception and null pointer exception. For the number format exception and null pointer exception, we need to define a separate recover method. Okay, so here now I am defining a recover method for number format exception. This method will return the string recover method number format exception. Whoever calling the API, if they face the number format exception, they will get the string response like recover method number format exception, likewise null pointer exception also. So whoever calling that API, if they get the null pointer exception, this recover method, the null pointer recover method, will call, and then they will get the response like recover method null pointer exception. Okay, so the recover method we returned successfully for one is number format and another one is a null pointer. Now I am going to add the sysout print line for sysout statement for number format exception and also the null pointer exception. So just want to make sure this recover method is calling or not. Okay, so I added the sysout for number format exception, and then now I am adding the sysout for null pointer exception, recover method, null pointer exception. Okay, so far we added the recover methods for null pointer and number format, and also already I added the sysout for my app API, I mean my app method. Okay, so we added that enable retry option, we added the recover response, recover, we defined the recover method for number format exception and null pointer exception, everything with the maximum number of attempts. Okay, now I am going to take a build of this application. So go to the command prompt, copy the location here, go to the command prompt, and then it's a Gradle project, right? So take a executable jar file by using the command Gradle clean build. It will create an executable jar file after the build is successful. Now go to the build and libs directory, run the jar file by using the command java-jar. So your Tomcat has started on the port 8080. Okay, so now I am going to hit the API, the default API. Okay, right now this method will not create any exception, so we will get the success response. So localhost colon 8080, so we get the success response. Okay, now I am going to inject the number format exception. Okay, so after this is out the println, I am going to inject the number format exception. So integer dot parse int of the empty string. So this will create, I mean this will generate the number format exception. I am taking a build. After the build successful, go to the build and libs directory, run the jar file by using the command java-jar. After the build successful, after the Tomcat has started on the port 8080, now go and hit the same API again in your web browser. So the number format exception will occur if we did the integer.parseInt of empty quote. So its maximum number of it will try. So my app API is calling. So maximum attempts are 5 times, the method is recalled again and again itself. And then after the fifth attempt, recover method is called. The recover method response, we got it in the web browser. So if any integer.parseInt, if any number format exception is occurred, this recover method will call. Okay, so this method will return the response to the client. Now I am going to add the null pointer exception here. So I am going to declare a string equal to null, and then I am trying to get the length of the string, null dot length. So in this case it will produce a null pointer exception. Okay, so null pointer exception is occurred, we will get the recover method response in the web browser. Again take a build of this application by using the command gradle clean build. After the build successful, go to the build and libs directory, run the jar file by using the command java-jar. Again the Tomcat has started on the port 8080. Okay, so after Tomcat has started, go to the web browser and hit the API. So now you can see the console, my app API is calling for 5 times. After the 5 times, the recover method null pointer exception is called. Okay, the recover method null pointer exception. So recover method of the null pointer exception is called, and then in the web browser also we got the response from the server, recover method null pointer exception. Okay, so this API has returns the recover method null pointer exception string to the client, whoever calling this API. Just make sure the return type should be the same of the retryable and recover method. Okay, so this is the null pointer case, and then the maximum attempts is 5. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and like my videos and share my videos. Thank you.